Hey, happy Friday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman. Plus, I got a big tropical update on what's going to be our potential next tropical wave, potentially our next storm or hurricane passing through. Plus, what's going to happen with Bermuda, because we're showing that Ernesto is going to be dangerously close towards Bermuda. Right now, they got the hurricane warnings up, showing that you will be in the hurricane winds. I'm showing that it will strengthen, but it will be on a weakening phase right before landfall. Still will be a hurricane, unfortunately, and bring some strong wind gusts, a lot of heavy rainfall, and you're potentially right on the eastern side of this hurricane. This is going to make for strong impacts. Then right after Ernesto, we're going to be dealing with our next tropical wave. Now remember, we do have the heat moving in, just like I told you in the last few videos, and it is going to be a very high ridge all the way into Canada. It is going to bring you cooler temperatures across the Great Lakes and the Northeast, but those are going to soon leave, and you're going to be in a different phase where the high pressure and the heat's going to be over here, and you're going to have cool air start rushing in as we go through September. Now you won't hear me talk about it except for this last update in this video, because y'all did not want to hear about the heat yesterday, and I'm sorry you didn't want to hear about the heat, but it is coming. But that's the way it is, so I won't mention it again, but I gotta talk to you about what's going on with this hurricane season. Now, matter of fact, we have a wave coming before our big threat at the very end of August, the very beginning of September, but we have a sneaky wave that's coming through all the way into the Gulf, not showing a lot of formation really coming out of that just yet, but we do need to watch it. But shortly after that, then we're going to get this potential hurricane that's going to be coming through. But at the same time, we're going to be going into our fall. So we're going to get this big trough that's going to be coming through, bringing cooler temperatures on down. And I know y'all are going to love it. But at the same time, this will help shear and push this system towards the east. Now, right now, I'm showing that the possible track of this system is going right from the Leeward Islands, just like we're seeing with Ernesto, but keep going towards the west and curve somewhere around the east coast. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long on weather forecasting. All I ask, if you know someone in these impacts or if you think this could help someone in any way, please consider hitting that like button down below or even hitting that share button to help put it in front of people's faces. Thank you so much for your time. But I do hope that y'all did pay attention to yesterday's video, because that heat is going to be some more dangerous heat moving through. You will hear other people talk about it. They cannot ignore it. It's going to be a high ridge all the way to the west coast, all the way into Canada. Remember that. Now look, you can see what's going to happen with Ernesto. It is going to strengthen up, but then it's going to get some dry air inside of it, right into the core of the system, and that is going to weaken it down. It's going to be on a weakening phase after that, down to a hurricane, but unfortunately it's not going to weaken enough right before impacts on Bermuda. But you also can see here that it is very formable storm, but then you can start see that the wind shear and the dry air starts getting in on the western side of this system as it gets closer and starts weakening that storm down. But it's already too late, because look how it does towards Bermuda. Literally brings all the impacts on the eastern side of the system, the winds and the rain, potentially a full impact of this hurricane. But I don't want to bring you just doom and gloom. I want to bring you some good news. So you can see how it strengthens up. This is your 10 meter winds. This is your intensity, showing it could go right up to a major hurricane and start intensifying. Right before landfall, it starts weakening down considerably because of that dry air and brings it all the way back down towards a hurricane, where you're still going to have very strong winds all the way into the high 70s, sustained winds, and potentially 100 or a little over 100 miles per hour wind gusts as this system comes right by the islands. You can see the same thing on another hurricane model. As it comes towards, it starts strengthening, but then it goes on that weakening trend right before impact. Unfortunately, you're still on the eastern side of the system, so you will be bringing all the winds and all the storm surge and all the major flooding. It is going to be a pretty rough scenario for all of you over there. So God bless all of you in the Bermuda Islands. I hope everything will be okay. To try and bring you some kind of information showing with the euro, as you go from midnight to 2 o'clock in the morning, it's going to start bringing potentially 30-foot waves, over 30-foot waves. Now, when you look with GFS, it shows it could be a little bit further to the east, which could still bring northern winds on the island as the eye comes across you. Then it'll be calm as it crosses you. Then it'll get rough again as it's leaving. But all the heavy waves could potentially be east of you, but still high 20-foot waves, still big enough. So as we look further with the euro, you can see chances for other impacts, your winds. showing maybe a up to 105 miles per hour wind gust could be coming over the islands, showing anywhere from 9 to 10 inches of rainfall coming in. This is with the Euro. When you go by the GFS, it's a little bit further to the east, but still bringing over 6 inches, showing one of your best case scenarios. You can even see the ICON model, which is accurate as well, is agreeing with the Euro, 9 to 10 inches of rainfall plus the storm surge. Now, this is still bringing some dangerous riptide currents towards the northeast, so be careful out there along the beaches. But it's not bringing traumatic impacts. I've seen people talk about, hey, you got to watch out. This is bringing 10, 20-foot waves. 10 isn't even that bad. You got to watch out for the potential impacts of your rip currents. But showing y'all waves is going to be very small. Maybe somewhere around 6 to 8 feet as that system passes by. No big impacts. But you do need to watch out towards Nova Scotia. It could be anywhere from 10 to 15-foot waves as this passes by. And then later on, the system is going to weaken down, but eventually move over towards the UK after it goes across the pond. So it is going to go towards their direction shortly after that. Also showing that after we go into August, late August, early September, we're going to start getting that transition, potentially bringing systems in our directions right into our path, right into our area, and it's going to continue to get stronger as we go through late September. This is all expected climatology, of course, but we do have something coming in the beginning of September showing it could form up late August, but potentially will be stronger chance for formation, favorable environment, lift in the atmosphere as you go through the beginning of September. Also showing by the Euro control member that after you deal with Ernesto going out, our next system is going to be forming up by the Leeward and Windward Islands, going west in the Caribbean, strengthening up as it passes by Hispaniola and Jamaica potentially. Look how it goes right to the Eastern Gulf and goes right up the East Coast, just like what we just had with Debby. When you go look at a chance for cyclone formations, you see literally in 10 days, that wave comes across weak, but starts building up over here in the Western Caribbean. Could be a sneaky wave that could get into our Gulf. We need to watch it. The trend has been weak so far, but you can see how it starts going active once we go late August into the beginning of September. And this is where it starts booming off of those tropical waves, showing they will potentially be curved around the high pressure because it's going to retract back over here towards Azores. And these systems are going to be going into this direction. Showing so far by the control member with the Euro, literally as we go 6 days, a weak tropical wave passing by the Leeward and Windward Islands. Showing no formation so far, but we do need to watch it because it does travel all the way into the Gulf of Mexico. So far showing that the dust keeps that suppressed, but we do need to watch it, look where it heads. At the same time, after that, this is where we start getting that tropical wave coming through and that favorable environment showing it will start strengthening up towards a hurricane as it goes by the Leeward and Windward Islands, and showing it will start curving around that high pressure going towards the west, northwest, right after that. That could easily go further to the west before the turn as well. Because you can see on the latest information, we get that broad expanding high pressure that comes out, and this keeps that system traveling further to the west. But then the system retracts all the way back towards Azores, and it's not really a Bermuda high no more, and that starts pulling that towards the west, northwest. Now on this shot, it's a little concerning because you can see we start going to that high ridge instead of a trough. That will allow that to come a lot closer towards the East Coast or lower 48. Still is too far away to be sure, because we still have that cold front that is coming through in the beginning of September as we change phases from a negative Pacific North American pattern into a positive phase. Still showing according to Global Tropics, they're still expecting a tropical formation, but not to last long once it leaves MDR. Your chances shrink from 40% to 20%. But as we go by the end of August and the very beginning of September, this is where it raises up for that chance for something to form up all the way to 60%. Plus, you also can see that as we go into this unfavorable conditions, it will change. As we go towards the end of August into the beginning of September, favorable environment is going to start moving in from the Eastern Pacific and go into our Gulf, our Caribbean, into our hurricane season, a pretty strong peaking point that's going to start being active. Nothing for the next 7 days, according to National Hurricane Center, but you are going to see an area of invest right there popping up shortly. Now, one thing that's going to mess with this tropical wave and steer it into that curve is this trough we're going to get. So remember, we still have this cooler air coming down. But first, remember, we have the heat coming in. It's going to ridge all the way to the West Coast, all the way into Canada, just like I showed you couple videos ago. Just give you the update a few days ago. Then we have the cool air coming in. Remember the last heat wave of the summer. And you can see the cool air retracts back as you go by the end of August all the way into the 20s. This is where you get that high ridge on the west coast going all the way into Canada for upper Midwest, bringing very hot temperatures like I told you multiple days ago. But then the cool air is going to come in and it's really going to settle in as we go all the way towards the 4th and the 5th. This is where the cool air is going to start cycling through the lower 48 and hanging around. Not going to be super cold, but this is going to hang around all the way as we go through September. And this is going to push into a different pattern. Because we're going to go into a positive PNA, which means that our trough is going to come in from the west coast from a negative PNA and travel all the way across the lower 48 to the east coast. So this is what it looks like while you're getting that high ridge of heat as we go towards the end of August. This is your negative PNA while you have this cool air start coming in from the west. Then you have this big high dome of heat. So remember, after it goes by Canada, it's still going by Ohio Valley and the Great Lakes. I'm showing that has not changed. Temperatures has mild down a little bit. But as you go from that negative PNA to a positive PNA, then you're going to see that trough carry on even further across the lower 48. So it looks a little confusing. You just got to know how to read the data. This is your Pacific North American pattern. This tells us which pattern we're going into for the lower 48. So you see we got this negative phase, then we got this positive phase, then we got quickly going back to this negative phase. So the negative phase, remember like I just showed you, it brings cool air on the west side of the lower 48. Positive phase will carry it towards the east side of the lower 48. And this is exactly what you see from National Weather Service for the next 6 to 10 days, that you have the cold air on the west coast, you got the cold air on the east coast. So you got that high dome of heat kicking in, big high pressure just sitting there, and you're still gonna get them cold air coming through for the nights. Daytime highs are gonna kick back up a little bit, but then we're gonna go into that negative phase after that, and the cold air is gonna come in from the west coast. Then we go to a positive phase, a long positive phase. And this is where our trough will transition from the west coast towards the east coast. But then you have that cold air that's coming on through after that, going into that positive phase. So remember, it's going from that negative to that positive. This is bringing that cold air from the west coast, and it's going to trough all the way down towards the east coast. And you can see this here from Climate Forecast System. So as you go into the beginning of September, you got that big high ridge of heat still kicking. You're going to be in the 80s. That's going to be a lot better than the 90s and 100s. But then we're going to go from that negative phase, the cold air coming in from the west coast, from that negative phase as we go from the 5th through the 10th, and it's going to go into that positive phase. While this cooler temperatures comes in beginning of September, and starts carrying further into the lower 48 and starts going further towards the east as we go into September for our fall. And there you go. There's your positive phase. And it is showing a little bit cooler temperatures than before. Still got your daytime highs in the 60s in the north, maybe the high 50s, the 70s and the 80s in the south. But the cooler air is going to hang around and this trough is going to hang around. So this trough is what's going to potentially push this system further towards the east and put some shear on it as it comes closer towards the coast. Now, as this trough comes in, we still got some severe weather chances for today and tomorrow. It's not a huge risk. There's no chances for tornadoes. It's going to be a little chance for winds like I showed you in yesterday's video. Even yesterday, there was no tornadoes reported. Just like I told you, more likely won't be any out of that section, and there wasn't any. So it's relaxed. Severe weather is going to be mild and down. There's no chances for these tornadoes, but you got to watch out for that chance for those hurricanes that's going to be coming up shortly. So be aware of those temperatures, everybody. I won't be reporting on it again. Y'all really did not want to hear about that yesterday, and I don't blame you. I'm from New Orleans, Louisiana most of my life, and I sweated at the school bus stop at 6 a.m. and it's just ridiculous down there. I know what it's like down there. There's going to be more heat all the way into the 20s of August. Then it's going to start maybe getting a little bit better for you. But I truly hope you'll have a great day and a great weekend. There's no threat for tornadoes. So tomorrow while in Sabbath, there won't be no upload, of course, because you're not supposed to work, especially if there's no lives at risk. That's according to God. But I will see you again on Sunday morning. Now, before you go today, Exodus 20, 8 through 11. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shalt thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within the gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that in them is, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Amen. Have a great weekend, everybody. I'll see you on Sunday morning. Remember, all glory does go to God our Father, Yahweh. And I always hope He keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great weekend, everybody. Watch for these storms. It's going to bring a little bit of wind, a little bit of hail. I don't see any tornadoes.